few years ago, there was a few videos on YouTube. They're still up. And it shows you how easy it is to get into a suitcase, no matter what type of lock you use. This one's only out of a Christmas cracker. And stick that on. And you think it's secure, nothing can get in there. But any unscrupulous bag handler, or anyone where the bag's lying around, can just get into the suitcase with a simple stab of a pencil or a pen. I mean, they can do whatever they want. And before you know it, they've got into your knickers or your computer or whatever's in your suitcase. And then they just fold this back round. Zip it up. And it's as if your bag's never been tampered with at all. And you'll probably never know until you get to the hotel. But the point of this video is cheap locks in general, really. I was in Poundland and I bought these two locks. I was really surprised with the range of stock they had on these ones because there were so many of the keys missing. And one weird thing about the keys for this lock is they've tied it on with tar wraps, what you wrap sandwiches in, like sandwich bag wraps. Like, normally when you see a lock like this, they get the key ringy bit and just thread it through. There's so many other ways they could have done this. They could have, you know, put the key and tie wrapped it onto this bit even, but no, they chose this sort of arrangement. Really weird. And the, oh yeah, and there's this one as well, which is from the Tommy Walsh range of stuff, DIY stuff. And, oh, gosh. Right, here's the key I took off earlier. And the lock is, you might wonder why I'm doing this. Well, I've been watching a lot of lock picking videos on YouTube recently. And the key goes in like, the key's quite tough, it didn't really go in very well. And it's like a spring-loaded sort of one, so it always jolts back. So I was wondering how easy it would be to just hack into this. And then inside, you'll see the spring-loaded sort of bit, which is at the bottom there, like that. So I'm going to try and hack into that and see if there's an easy way to break into this. Because I'm thinking for 100 pence, there's not going to be a whole lot of quality in there. Yet, bizarrely, it does carry the Poundland quality guarantee. Very weird. Then there's this one. Ooh, the keys again all looked really, really similar. What's this feel like? It says it's waterproof. Anyway, it says it's hardened on the front. I don't think that's going to zoom in. There we go. Doesn't say it on both sides, but they have randomly printed his name on both sides. Very weird. Ooh, that's a really good sound of quality, that, isn't it? Oh, look at that! They just slide up. Yeah, I think water's going to get in there. I feel like I can peel all this away with my fingers. What is going on? Yeah, let's get in there. See, look, these had the right idea. They know how to put keys on. Just get one of the keys off. This feels really cheap, obviously. Oh, the lock comes out like that. I see. So who's going to be bothered to put all this back on if it keeps falling to pieces? This can't possibly be waterproof. Let's get the key in there. Is that it? Is that how the key goes in? Is that open? Does the key even work? Oh yeah, that's going to keep falling off. That's just going to break off. No one's going to have this on there like that. That's just going to come off right away. So that's that off. So it's just a lock, padlock, cheap, tacky one, obviously, with a bit of rubber on it and this sort of hard plastic thing, which has just cracked. So that was, yeah, very, very secure. I'm sure this can be hacked into. And I'm going to time it. That's why my phone's here. I'm going to saw into this. And I'm going to see what happens. I want to see what's inside. Oh, this is so easy. Oh, my word, look. I was cutting through the metal, look. This metal is so thin. This isn't even a new saw. I'm gonna go for the weakest point of that. Oh God, I've just scratched my phone. No. Right. Well, since this bit's exposed, might as well just cut through that, haven't I? And there we are. Look at that. But with a blunt saw, less than 7 minutes, I was in. This is really nice. Look how thin the metal is inside. It's just all plastic. I mean, how easy is the plastic to cut into? I'm through to the metal already. My hands are covered in little black bits and bits of metal now. That was really difficult to do. I'm sweating like a pig, but I'm gonna try and go this way because this bit's all taffly and doing my head in. No, just don't buy that. For this one, I managed to scratch up the screwdriver, and even though this bit is hardened, clearly this bit isn't, and it's really easy to get into there. So you'll be able to just chop this off as well. Well, thanks for watching, Scrass. See you when I see you. Bye.